Yo, 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 what is going on, everyone? Thank you again for tuning in, as always. Much appreciated. My name is Dutchline, and in this video, we are continuing with the Binturong enclosure. We started on this enclosure in the previous episode, and today we're going to finish it with the rockwork, of course, and also with the foliage. There will be one or two buildings added to the enclosure as well, and this is to accommodate the shelter for the Binturongs, because as of now, it's only a plain field with rocks, a pathing system, and a climbing frame. Those bits were added in the previous episode, so I'll link the video in the description down below and also get like the top right corner thingy going as well. If you haven't checked that one out yet, feel free to do so, because then you get up to date with how these bits have been placed and created in the first place. The Binturongs already had a previous enclosure, of course, which is, or was, close to the Chinese palace. And we're going to be putting in this enclosure instead, because the enclosure that we're building now is a walkthrough enclosure, and the whole idea is to put as many animals from the Southeast Asia DLC in this village. And the Binturongs were pretty much the only animal that we could pick for that reason. So what we did is changing the Binturong enclosure into a Babirusa enclosure instead. It was quite easy to do, like one or two things had to be taken away and added to make sure that the enclosure is safe for them. So that's all up and running now. But the enclosure now that we're building is for the for the Binturongs. So it will be accessible for the guests. As you can see, there's a lot of pathing system going on right now. Like, they're pretty big patches, but as you can see in screen, pretty much right now, you'll see that we are adding some rocks in to add that to the overall aesthetics as well. For the overall look, we are gonna go for the more foresty feel. You'll see that in this video as well, because we are going to be placing the foliage in two. We're using the same foliage items that we've been using for the natural decoration videos and the enclosure for the dolls. Also, I'll leave a link in the description down below and in the top right thingy. So if you haven't checked that one out either, then please make sure you do, so you get like up to date with the whole village as a whole. Because we have been building in this area of the zoo for quite some time now. I would say like the making of this video around 2.5, almost 3 months. So it's like a pretty darn long process. But overall, it's super fun to do still after all this time, because we're getting to the end. Because after this one, this video and enclosure that is, we're going to be decorating the outside area of the castle, because that's also still something that needs to be done. And whenever that is completed, we get like most of the things done for the village itself. We'll be adding a couple extra things to it though in the future, especially the open area in between the exhibit section of the zoo and the Japanese village. There's like a little open plain field, so to speak, going, so we're gonna be placing another enclosure there too. That enclosure is being built right now on Twitch, because all the videos you see on YouTube have been created live over on Twitch, using the gameplay from those streams to turn those into YouTube videos, as like this one. A quick disclaimer though for this video, it's more in the end. Unfortunately, there are a lot of moments where the camera like stops a little bit. Like, we had a little bit of difficulty whenever we were building this enclosure, especially at the end, because we're making some sort of a treehouse type building, and personally I wasn't entirely sure on like how to do that or how to make it look. So I tried to cut off as many of those freezing moments, but unfortunately there's still a couple in this video, so I do apologize. You will see that later in the video if you do stick around. So yeah, like, I tried my best to take as many out as possible, but again, unfortunately there's still a couple in this video. But going back to those Twitch streams, I'll leave a link in the description down below as well. If you haven't checked any of those live streams out, then please feel free to do so, because it is a overall chill stream. If you do like those type of live streams, then it will be the place for you. If you have like questions or just overall thing that you want to show, also for Discord, I'll leave a link in the description down below as well. You can like share the builds, ask questions, chat about upcoming DLCs, information, all that stuff. It is in those live streams. So feel free, once again, to check out the stream in the future if you haven't already. Now though, I will leave you with the remaining of the speed build. Hopefully you will enjoy as always. Once again, I will leave all the links in the description down below and in the top right corner for the previous videos if you haven't checked those ones out yet. In the future, we're going to be building on the castle and a whole lot of other good stuff. So feel free to stick around if you do enjoy these type of videos. And yeah, once again, thank you very much for the support. It means a lot. It's very kind of you all to keep on watching these videos. It really does mean a whole bunch. But for now, I will leave you all with the remaining of the speed build. Hopefully you will enjoy. I will see you all later. Stay safe. Have a good one. Bye-bye.